Hello friends, so in this video we are going to create a really cool and a really simple software manager program by just writing few lines of bash code. So let me just quickly show you how this thing works. If I press super N in my computer, it's going to show me this D menu prompt, which is asking for a particular action. So this program can do 4 actions. One, it can install any program. It can remove any program. Also, it can remove waste, which is basically just removing the orphan packages. These are the packages which have nothing to do. It's just sitting in your computer for no reason. Also, the last thing I can do is update the system. So let me just try updating my system first. So as you can see here, something is getting downloaded in my system.
Hey, listen!
And here I got this cute little notification which is saying that your system is completely up to date now. So let me try installing a program now. If I press super N again and just type install program, press enter. So here I got the list of all the possible programs which I can install from the remote Arch repository. So let me just try searching a program, for example, NeoFetch. So this menu is showing a bunch of things about that particular package. One, the name of the package. Second, the size of the package. Third, the repo. And fourth, a small description about that particular package, which can be very useful sometimes. So if I press enter now. So here my new fetch is installed. So once again, let me quickly just demonstrate to you how to remove a package. If I press enter on remove package, it's going to give me the list of all the packages which are currently installed in my system. Also, if you focus here, this is not the download size of the package. This is the installed size. So when I was installing a program, I am getting the download size, but when I'm removing the program, I'm getting the installed size. Okay. So if I press enter. So as you can see here, my package is removed. So let me now show you how you guys can create this program. So if you type pacman minus q in your computer and press enter, it's going to show you all the packages which are currently installed in your system. But if I want some more information about these packages, I can add this I option here and press enter. So now with the package, I'm also getting its version, description and bunch of other information about that particular package. Also, instead of pacman minus qi, if I run pacman minus si, it's just going to give me all the packages which are present in the remote Arch repository. So the next thing I have to do is I have to just fetch the things which I need from this data. For example, the name, installed size, and its description. So with the help of pacman tips and tricks Arch wiki, I got this cute little way to get name and install size. So let me just quickly run this. So here I got the size and here I got the package name. So let's just quickly understand what this awk is doing here. So let me first remove this sort minus h from here and let me just minimize this code. Just try to print name and nothing else. So if I press enter here, here I got all the name. So what this code is doing is it's going to search for this pattern, and if it found this pattern, it's just going to print the whole line. And one more thing, this caret symbol here means just making sure that name must be in the start of the line and not somewhere else. So from this, how I'm going to get just the name of the package and nothing else? So for awk, this is the dollar symbol 1, this is the dollar symbol 2, and this is the dollar symbol 3. So what I have to do now is just print dollar symbol 3, and here I'm getting just the package name and nothing else. So instead of printing it here, I can just store it in a name variable and just repeat this thing again, but for this time for install size. So here I wrote the code just to print installed size, and if I press enter now, it's going to give me just the installed size. So again, for awk, this is dollar symbol 1, this is dollar symbol 2, this is dollar symbol 3, this is dollar symbol 4, and this is dollar symbol 5. Okay, so what I want is only dollar symbol 4 and 5. Let me just print dollar symbol 4 and dollar symbol 5, and if I press enter now, so here I got what I want. So again, instead of printing this, let's just store it into a variable. So is for install size equals to dollar symbol 4 dollar symbol 5. So yeah, same thing I did for repo, and now it's time for description, which was the tricky one. Why? Let me just show you. Let me just try to grab description and let me just print it. So yeah, I got the data which I want. Let me just try to print the dollar symbol 3rd and just press enter, and I'm just getting the first word. So this is the issue in description, that in other cases I only had to grab one word, so it was okay. But in description, if you focus here. So this is dollar symbol 1, this is dollar symbol 2, and this is dollar symbol 3, and this is dollar symbol 4. So I don't know how many are there. This could be long. So how I'm going to get this? Well, it was not that hard. If I do here dollar symbol 0 and press enter, it's just going to give me the whole line, and all I have to do is somehow I have to remove this starting 18 characters. Okay, so there is a cute little function which is sub function, which stand for substitute. Let me just show you how this works. So this requires three argument. First is the pattern you want to remove. So I want to remove caret, which means from starting, dot, which means any character, and then 18. Any character goes for like 18. And then second argument is replace to. I mean, from which string I want to replace this. So I can just type empty string here. And if I press comma, the third argument is what string you want to do this operation on. So dollar symbol 0, which means the whole string. So what this thing will do is it will remove the starting 18 character from that particular string. And if I try to print this now, so here I'm getting just a description and not those starting characters. Now instead of printing just description, let me just try to print other things like the variables which we created before too. So yes, we can do this. We can just type name comma and then is comma and then the description. So if I press enter, so here I got the package name, then the size of the package, and then description. So yeah, I can easily just format it a little. So here I can just add this arrow symbol. I can just simply add the square bracket around this install size. So here I got my data the way exactly I wanted it to be. So if I search any package here, for example screen fetch, and press enter, it's just going to give me this line. And I can use awk program again to just print the first word. So if now I press enter and search screen fetch again and press enter, I'm only getting screen fetch, and I can just make a variable out of it and type sudo pacman minus s or r, whatever operation I want to do, and run it. So yeah, it's running perfectly. So now with all this basic understanding, let's see what's in my script. So the first thing I'm doing is just getting what action I want to do. So here I'm using dmenu, but again, you can also use fuzzy finder. It's very simple. Also, I'm showing this prompt software manager. You can just write anything here, whatever you like. And then here on line 5, I'm using switch statement. And then I'm just doing what I just told you, but in a little more nicer way. I'm just getting package and then installing package here and giving notification. One more thing to notice, I am using this minus minus no confirm flag, which is very important because this just skips that yes no prompt which you get in Pacman. The same thing I am doing for removing package. The only difference is here I'm using minus q instead of minus s, so I'm getting the packages which are currently installed in my system. Also here I'm just getting download size, but here I am getting install size. So keep that in mind. And here I don't have to do any awk magic. I'm just running this command which I get from archwiki, which is used to delete any orphan packages. And in the last, I don't think I have to explain you anything further. So I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, then please write comment and tell me how much you liked it and what things I can improve in my videos. Also, you can suggest me what kind of videos you want to see in future. Down, yeah. I've been feeling so down, yeah. Can you tell me why? Can you tell me why I'm down, yeah? No friends of mine, no friends of mine around.